Merry Christmas, even though it's only Christmas Eve. Oh, actually, yes. I can see the camera, but you can't see me, 'cause I isn't this the coolest thing in the world? All right, I will say thank you very much to my lovely girlfriend Vicky for this, 'cause look at it, for goodness sake, it's brilliant, isn't it? Who doesn't want a Jensen button mask in their life, apart from maybe Lewis Hamilton? So, enough of that. That's 31 seconds of your life you'll never get back. Really apologizing. It's Christmas Eve. There's like Christmas tomorrow, so I'll stick this online. And there's just no tinsel because it's tinsel last week and next week. Part three. It'll be in another country still because you know I'm in a different country than the one I did last week. And this is my graduation gown and my beret, so don't worry about that. It's fine. It's just bits of my life. Yeah, so I'm a different country. Let's get on with season review part two. Merry Christmas to you all. Have you a lovely, lovely Christmas. A fantastic New Year. Well, then next week, there will be a video before New Year, probably, maybe. So I wish you good. There will be two of us. We'll wish you good luck next week for the coming year. I have had a request, or a half request this week, to wish someone a Merry Christmas. So Merry Christmas to all of you, and Merry Christmas to someone called Steph, who's apparently half Scottish, half Polish. So I've been into my lexicon of things, and I only know like the words like dziękuję, which is thank you in Polish. But you all knew that anyway, thanks to Borat. So I've worked out what Merry Christmas is, and my goodness me, it's the most complicated thing in the world. It's not just Merry Christmas. I've written it down phonetically. So here goes. It's wyzuć smuć bujek yo narodzenia. No idea what that means. So Steph, when we meet, please teach me how to say Merry Christmas in Polish, because I don't know. That's my best. So wyzuć smuć bujek that's my best shot. So let's kick it off. I have my depressingly timed timer, which does a minute, and it's still as from last week. Still says a minute, and it's still got exactly the same ringtone. So you can tell how exciting my life has been in the last 7 days by way of timing things. Let's get on with it, shall we? So, Scuderia Ferrari, start. I think they have a really good season. The car was very, very, very slow at the beginning, but very, very quick at the end. Fernando Alonso should have won the title, as I said in Germany, but look what happened from Germany onwards. I think Ferrari doing well. Massa cried, everyone went, woo! He sort of got his mojo back towards the end of the season, so if they do a good car next year, who knows what ha might happen to him. Yeah, Alonso should have won the title. He's very passionate, very like enthusiastic and passionate. Yeah, I think they were just sort of they were vying for podiums and wins, the both of them. The both of them, does that make sense? You can see I'm really rambling because Ferrari have just had like an okay season. They should have probably done better given their driver and the final pace of their car. I think if they build a decent car next, if they put into their Formula One cars what they're doing to their road cars now, they could do really well. Let's just see what happens with them. Two, one. I don't know how it vibrates. I just want bells. Does like Westminster Abbey vibrate when it rings its bells? No. Why does my phone? Anyway, so that's cool. Mercedes GP. Ha! Ross Brawn doesn't give you everything, does he? Schumacher, let's get on with him first. I hate him. He's a cheat. I don't like him in the same way I don't. Well, no, actually, I don't hate him. Hate is a strong word. In the same way, I don't like Ayrton Senna. They're just a bit flawed. I think his comeback was useless. But he's gone now, so that's happy times. He can just go off into the sunset and make some more money on things. Nico Rosberg. I was mentioning last week about Paul di Resta and the most boring person in the world. If you were going to say, like, ah, oh, describe drivers by colours, Fernando Alonso would be red and passionate, and Nico Rosberg would be beige. He's just sort of a. Nico Rosberg, he's honestly. He's rubbish. I think when the new rules come in, probably in like 2014, we'll see what happens with them, because it could be brilliant and Ross Brawn could be up to something, and Lewis Hamilton, I don't know what he's going to do with them, but he's gone to them for more money, so it's just like a bit weird. There you go. See, if you rant. Goes a lot quicker. Whereas if you go in a sort of Ferrari pensive sort of Italian way, you know, Damn, you're gonna have to drink now, aren't you? Because that was a foreign voice. Coolio. Williams, start. I've always said Bruno Senna's trading off his uncle's name. That's a bit unfair. He's probably not, because he was banned from motor racing after the you-know-what. I don't think he's got the development, so I think it's a bit too late for him, which is why he's been substituted for hashtag Bottas. Sorry, Dean, if you're messing about with the sound levels on the... really sorry. Also, Grace as well. Maldonado has been utterly useless. Sorry, Vicky. Feel free to beat me next time you see me. But he's utterly useless, and it's only by fluke that he won the Spanish Grand Prix. I don't know what happened there. Next season, don't know what's going to happen. Don't know, really. I think Bottas will probably do better than Maldonado. Just come in and just take it by the scruff of the neck, as Finns do, and go for it. So, Williams... All right, season this season, but we're hoping for better things with Bottas next season. Pretty good, isn't it? Right, Marussia. I can't say Marussia with a straight face. Marussia, that's better. I don't know why Richard Branson has to do his whole like bet with Tony Fernandez, because he's not really responsible for the team or the day to day running of the team. It should probably have been like, yeah, who knows? Our favourite Irish driver, Tim O'Glock. He did. All right this season, I have to say. He did all right. Charles Pic, don't know why he's gone to Caterham. In fact, no, I do know why he's gone to Caterham. We sit here on Twitter all the time, and we talk about Marussia F1 Will, who last week in Fan Formula was like, oh, Marussia are going to overtake Caterham. Tosh, are they, you disillusioned idiot. So, what does that say? One of your main drivers at Marussia has gone to Caterham. He would only go there for one reason, and that was because they have a better car. So we'll see what happens in them. I think Marussia are just going to have a meh season next season, but I think this season they're also meh. It was a bit insulting, but sorry. I think they're a bit sort of like... None of the midfield teams, there's no, you know, as Thierry Henry would famously said, Eilish, va-va-voom. There's no va-va-voom in the back of the grid. So there you go. Really, really, really sorry to Grace for requesting the questions early and not delivering, but due to the high winds and the rain, we were very tired on Sunday morning and we had to get places, so Fan Formula sort of got postponed until now. But rest assured, please, if you're watching this, Grace, which you are, because you're going to have to edit it. So yeah, Grace, can I have the questions early again, please, for next week? And I promise, or not early, but like Sunday morning, rather than like, yeah, I promise. Not to let you down, because I don't like letting people down. It's bad for my health. So look after yourself. Have a wonderful festive time. All of you, drink port and sherry and things. Do things that you're only allowed to do at Christmas, like stay in your pyjamas all day. And yes, no, that is, you're only allowed to do that at Christmas. Otherwise, you're lazy. Stay in your pyjamas all day, eat ice cream, gorge yourself on mince pies for breakfast, lunch and dinner. Just go mad. If you're working over the festive period, I say the festive period between Christmas and New Year, good luck, and I hope the sales don't like cripple you. I think that's it. I think that's all I've got to say. Merry Christmas, and I will see you next week at some point for part 3 and the last part of Fan Formula, which will be coming to you from a rather glamorous location. So, from me and JB, Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, talk to you soon.